It's all right. I came back.
Why? What happened? Did something happen?
No, nothing happened.
You didn't smash the car again, did you?
I said nothing happened. Didn't you hear me?
Don't you feel well?
Tired to death. I couldn't make it, Linda. I just couldn't make it.
Where were you all day? You look terrible.
Got as far as a little above Yonkers. I stopped for a cup of coffee. Maybe it was the coffee.
What?
Suddenly, I couldn't drive anymore, you know? The car kept going off into the shoulder.
Well, maybe it's the steering. I don't think Angelo knows the Studebaker.
No. It's me. It's me. Suddenly, I was going 60 miles an hour, and I couldn't remember the last 5 minutes. I can't seem to keep my mind to it.
Well, maybe it's your glasses. You never went for new glasses.
No, I see everything. I came back at 10 miles an hour. It took me nearly 4 hours from Yonkers.
Well, you're just going to have to rest, dear. You know you can't continue this way.
But I just got back from Florida.
But you didn't rest your mind, dear. Your mind is overactive, and the mind is what counts.
Well, I'll start out in the morning. Maybe I'll feel better in the morning. These goddamn art supports are killing me.
Take an aspirin. Shall I get you an aspirin? It'll suit you.
I was driving along, you understand? And I was fine. I was even observing the scenery. You can imagine me looking at the scenery on the road every week of my life. But it's so beautiful up there, Linda. The trees are thick and the sun is warm. I opened the windshield and just let the warm air bathe over me. And then, all of a sudden, I'm telling you, I absolutely forgot I was driving. If I'd gone the other way over the white line, I might have killed somebody. So I went on again. 5 minutes later, I'm dreaming again. I have such thoughts, such strange thoughts.
Willie, dear, talk to them again. There's no reason you can't work in New York.
They don't need me in New York. I'm the New England man. I'm vital in New England.
But you're 60 years old. They can't expect you to keep traveling every week.
I have to send a wire to Brown and Morrison tomorrow morning. I'm supposed to see them at 10 o'clock to show the line. God damn it, I could sell them.
Why don't you go down to the place tomorrow and tell them that you've simply got to work in New York?
If old Frank Wagner was alive, I'd be in charge of New York right now. That man was a prince. He was a masterful man. But that boy of his, that Howard, he don't appreciate. When I went north the first time, the Wagner Company didn't even know where New England was.
Well, why don't you tell those things to Howard, dear?
Oh, I will. I definitely will. Is there any cheese?
I'll make you a sandwich.
No. Go to sleep. I'll be right up. I'll take some milk. Boys asleep?
They're sleeping. Happy took Biff on a date tonight.
Not so.
It was so wonderful to see them shaving together, one behind the other in the bathroom, and going out together. You notice? The whole house smells of shaving lotion.
Figure it out. Work a lifetime to pay off a house. You finally own it. There's no one to live in it.
Well, dear, life's a casting off. It's always that way.
Oh. Now, some people accomplish something. Did Biff say anything after I left this morning?
You shouldn't have criticized him, Willie. Especially after you just got off the train. You mustn't lose your temper with him.
When the hell did I lose my temper? I simply asked him if he was making any money. Is that a criticism?
Dear, how can he make money?
There's such an undercurrent in him. He became a moody man. Did he apologize after I left?
He was crestfallen. Willie, you know how he admires you. I think that if he finds himself, you'll both be happier. Not fight anymore?
Did he find himself on a farm? Is that a life? A farmhand? In the beginning, when he was young, I thought, well, a young man, it's good for him to tramp about. Take a lot of different jobs. But it's more than 10 years now, Linda, and he's yet to make $34 a week.
He's finding himself, Willie.
Not finding yourself at the age of 34 is a disgrace.
Shh.
The trouble is, he's lazy, goddammit.
Willie, please.
Biff is a lazy bum.
They're sleeping. Get something to eat. Go on down.
Why did he come home? I would like to know what brought him home.
I don't know. I think that he's lost, Willie. I think he's very lost.
Biff Ullman is lost? In the greatest country in the world, a young man with such personal attractiveness gets lost? And such a hard worker. There's one thing about Biff. He's not lazy.
Never.
I'll see him in the morning. I'll have a nice talk with him. I'll get him a job selling. He could be big in no time. Remember the way they used to follow him around in high school? When he smiled at them, their faces lit up. When he walked down the street.
Willie, I got a new kind of American cheese today. It's whipped.
Why do you get American when I like Swiss?
I thought you'd like a change.
I don't want a change. I want Swiss cheese. Why am I always being contradicted?
I thought it would be a surprise, dear.
Why don't you open a window in here, for God's sake?
They're all open, dear.
The way they boxed us is in here. Bricks and windows. Windows and bricks.
You know, we should have bought the land next door.
The street is lined with cars. You can't get a breath of fresh air in the neighborhood anymore. The grass don't go. You can't raise a carrot in the backyard. I should have had a law against apartment houses. Remember those two beautiful elm trees out there? When I and Biff hung the swing between them?
Yeah. Like being a million miles from the city.
I should have arrested the builder for cutting those down. They massacred the neighborhood. More and more I think of those days, Linda. This time of year was lilac and wisteria. And the peonies would come out, and the daffodils. What fragrance in this room?
Well, after all, people have to move somewhere.
No, there's more people now.
I don't think there's more people.
There's more people. That's what's ruining this country. Population is getting out of control. The competition is maddening. Smell the stink from that apartment house and one on the other side. How can they whip cheese?
Go on down and try it, dear. Just be quiet.
You're not worried about me, are you, sweetheart?
You've got too much on the ball to worry about, dear.
You're my foundation and my support, Linda.
Just try and relax. You make mountains out of molehills.
I won't fight with him anymore. If he wants to go back to Texas, let him go.
He'll find his way.
Sure. Certain men just don't get started till later in life. Like Thomas Edison, I think. Or B.F. Goodrich. One of them was deaf. I'll put my money on Biff.
Biff. I think Papa's back.
And Willie, if it's warm on Sunday, we can drive in the country, open the windshields, and take lunch.
No, the windshields don't open on the new cars.
But you opened them today, dear.
Me? I didn't. Oh, isn't that peculiar? Isn't that remarkable?
What, dear?
That is the most remarkable thing.
What, darling?
I could have sworn I was driving that Chevy today. 1928 when I got that red Chevy. Isn't that funny? I could have sworn I was driving that Chevy.
Oh. Well, that's nothing. Something must have reminded you, that's all.
Remarkable. Remember the way Biff used to Simonize that car? The dealer refused to believe there was 80,000 miles on it. Close your eyes. Be right up.
Jesus, maybe he smashed up the car again.
The cheese, it's in the middle shelf, dear.
He's going to get his license taken away if he keeps that up. I'm getting nervous about him. You know, Biff?
His eyes are going.
Now I've driven with him. He sees all right, he just doesn't keep his mind to it. I drove into the city with him last week. He stops at a green light, then it turns red and he goes.
Well, maybe he's colorblind.
Pop white. He's got the finest eye for color in the business, you know that.
I'm going to sleep.
You're not still sour on Dad, are you, Biff?
He's all right, I guess.
Yes, sir. 80,000 miles. 82,000.
You smoking?
Want one?
What a Simonizing job.
I can never sleep when I smell it.
Honey, Biff. You know, us sleeping in here again. The old beds. All the talk that went across these two beds, huh? Whole lives.
Yeah. A lot of dreams and plans.
About 500 women would like to know what we said in this room.
Do you remember that big Betsy something? What the hell was her name? The one over on Bushwick Avenue?
Oh, with the collie dog.
Right. I got you in there, remember?
Oh, yeah. It was my first time, I think. Boy, there was a pig. You taught me everything I know about women. Don't forget that.
I bet you forgot how bashful you used to be, especially around girls.
Oh, I still am.
Oh, go on.
I just control it, that's all. I think I got less bashful around girls, and you got more so. What happened, Biff? Where's the old humor, old confidence? What's the matter?
Why does Dad mock me all the time?
He's not mocking.
Everything I see, there's a twist of mockery in his face. I can't get near him.
He just wants you to make good, that's all. I've been meaning to talk to you about Dad for a long time, Biff. Something's happening to him. He talks to himself.
I noticed that this morning. but he's always mumbled.
But not so noticeable. It got so embarrassing, I had to send him to Florida. You know something, Biff. Most of the time he's talking to you.
What's he say about me?
Oh, I can't make it out.
What's he say about me?
I guess the fact that you're not settled, that you're still kind of up in the air.
There's one or two other things depressing him, Hap.
What do you mean?
Never mind. Just don't lay it all to me, all right?
But I think if you got started, I mean, is there any future for you out there?
Hap, I don't know what the future is. I don't know what I'm supposed to want.
What do you mean?
Well, for 6 or 7 years after high school, I tried working myself up. Shipping clerk, salesman, business of one kind or another. And it's a measly manner of existence. To get on that hot train in the morning, to devote your whole life to keeping stock, or making phone calls, or buying or selling, to suffer 50 weeks of the year for the sake of a 2-week vacation, when all you really desire is to be out there with your shirt off. And always to have to get ahead of the next fella. And still, that's how you make a future.
Well, you really like it on a farm? Are you content out there?
Hap, I've had 20 or 30 different kinds of jobs since I left home before the war. And they all kind of turned out the same. I just realized it recently. In Nebraska, when I herded cattle, and the Dakotas, and Arizona, and now in Texas. That's why I came home, I guess, because I realized it. This farm I work on, it's spring there now, seeing they've got about 15 new colts. Now, there's nothing more inspiring or beautiful as the sight of a mare and a new colt, and it's cool now. Texas is cool, and it's spring. And whenever spring comes to where I am, I get the feeling, my God, I'm not getting anywhere. I mean, what the hell am I doing playing around with horses, $28 a week? I'm 34 years old. I ought to be making my future. That's when I come running home, and now I get here, and I don't know what to do with myself. I've always made a point of not wasting my life. And every time I come home, I know that all I've done is waste my life.
You're a poet. You know that, Biff? You're an idealist.
Nah, I mixed up very bad. Maybe I ought to get married. Maybe that's my trouble. I'm not stuck in anything. I'm like a boy. I'm not married. I'm not in business. I'm like a boy. What about you, Hap? Are you content? You're a success, aren't you? Are you content?
Oh, no.
Well, why not? You're making money, aren't you?
All I can do now is wait for the merchandise manager to die. And suppose I get to be the merchandise manager. He's a good friend of mine, and he just built a terrific estate out on Long Island. And he lived there about 2 months and sold it. And now he's building another one. He can't enjoy it once it's finished. And I know that's just what I would do. I don't know what the hell I'm working for. Some days I just sit in my apartment all alone. And I think of the rent I'm paying. It's crazy. Then it's what I always wanted. My own apartment, a car, plenty of women. Still, goddammit, I'm lonely.
Listen, why don't you come out west with me?
You and I, huh?
Sure, we could buy a ranch, raise some cattle, use our muscles. I mean, men built like we are should be working out in the open.
The Lohman brothers, huh?
Sure, we'd be known all over the counties.
Oh, Biff, that's what I dream about. Some days I just want to rip my shirt off in the middle of that store and outbox that goddamn merchandise manager. I mean, I can outbox, outrun, outlift anybody in that store. And I still have to take orders from those common, petty sons of bitches till I can't stand it anymore.
I'm telling you, kid, if you were out there with me, I'd be happy.
See, Biff, everybody around me is so false that I'm constantly lowering my ideals.
Maybe together we'd have someone we could rely on, somebody we could trust.
Oh, if I were around you.
Crap, the trouble is we weren't brought up to grub for money. I don't know how to do it.
Neither can I.
Then let's go.
The only thing is, what can you make out there?
But look at your friend. builds an estate than hasn't the peace of mind to live in it.
Yeah, but when he walks into the store, the waves part in front of him. That's $52,000 a year coming through the revolving door. And I got more in my pinky finger than he's got in his head.
Yeah, but you just said...
I just gotta show some of those pompous, self-important executives over there that... Hap Lohman can make the grade. I want to walk into the store the way he walks in.
Then I'll go with you, Biff.
We'll be together yet, I swear, but take those two we had tonight. Now, weren't they gorgeous creatures?
Yeah. Yeah, most gorgeous I've had in years.
I get that any time I want. Whenever I feel disgusted. The only thing is, it's to be like bowling or something. Just keep knocking him over and it doesn't mean anything. You still like to run around a lot?
Nah, I'd like to find a girl steady, you know, someone with substance.
That's what I long for.
Oh, go on. You'd never come home.
I would. Someone with character, with resistance. Like Mom, you know?
Oh, you're gonna call me a bastard when I tell you this.
That girl Charlotte I was with tonight is engaged to be married in 5 weeks.
No kidding.
Sure, the guy's in line for vice presidency of the store. I don't know what gets into me. Maybe I just have an overdeveloped sense of competition or something. But I went and ruined her. And furthermore, I can't get rid of her. And he's the third executive I've done that to. Is that a crummy characteristic? And to top it all off, I go to their weddings. Like I'm not supposed to take bribes. Manufacturers offer me a $100 bill now and then to throw an order their way. And you know how honest I am, but it's like this girl, see? I hate myself for it. Because I don't want the girl. But still, I take it. And I love it. What's the matter?
I'm just going to sleep.
Guess we didn't settle much of anything, did we?
I just got one idea I think I'm going to try.
What's that?
Do you remember Bill Oliver?
Sure, Oliver's very big now. Do you want to work for him again?
No, but when I left, he said something to me. He put his arm around my shoulder and he said, Biff, if you ever need anything, come see me.
I remember that. That sounds good.
I think I'll see him. If I could get $10,000 or even $7,000 or $8,000, I could buy a beautiful ranch.
I bet he'd back you. Because he thought highly of you, Biff.
They all do. We're well liked.
That's why I say to come here, and we both have the apartment, and I'm telling you, Biff, any babe you want.
With a ranch, I could do the work I like and still be something. I just wonder, though. I wonder whether Oliver still thinks I stole that carton of basketballs.
Oh, he probably forgot about that long ago. It's almost 10 years. You're too sensitive. Anyway, he didn't really fire you.
Yeah, well, I think he was going to. I think that's why I quit. I could never tell whether he knew or not. Still, he did like me. I was the only one he'd ever let lock up the place.
You gonna wash the engine, Biff?
Shh! You hear that?
Don't get your sweater dirty, Biff!
Doesn't he know Mom can hear that?
What a simonizing job, huh?
Isn't that terrible? Don't leave again, will you? You gotta stick around. You'll find a job here. I don't know what to do about him. It's getting embarrassing.
Mom's hearing that.
You got a date? Wonderful.
Go on to sleep, but talk to him in the morning, will you?
With her in the house, brother!
I wish you'd have a good talk with him.
That selfish, stupid...
Sleep, Biff.
Just want to be careful with those girls, that's all, Biff. Don't make any promises. No promises of any kind. As a girl, you know, I always believe what you tell them, and you're very young, Biff. Too young to be talking seriously to girls. Too young entirely, Biff. You want to watch your school at first, then, when you're all set, there'll be plenty of girls for a boy like you. That's so. The girls pay for you. Well, you must be really making a hit. I've been wondering why you polished the car so careful. Boys, make sure you get the hubcap. Get the chamois to the hubcaps. Oh, Biff, why don't you show Happy how to use the newspaper on the windows? It's the easiest thing. Just show him, Biff. That's right. That's right. Pat it up. Use it like a pen. You're doing all right now. Biff, first thing we got to do when we get the chance is cut down that big branch over the roof. Afraid it's going to fall down in a storm and hit the house. Tell you what. We throw a nice rope over there and climb up with a couple of saws and cut her down. Oh, Biff, as soon as he finished the car, I got a surprise for you.
What do you got, Dad?
No. You finish first. Never leave a job until you're finished. Remember that. Biff, up in Albany, I saw a beautiful hen. I think I'll buy it next trip and hang it right between those two elms. Wouldn't that be something? Just swinging there under those branches? Boy, that would be something. Because that was a beautiful hammock, Biff. I'm telling you, the stitching and the... Why, I haven't seen something that beautiful in years. As a matter of fact, everything they sold in that store...
How's that, Pop? Professional?
Terrific. Terrific job, boys. Good work, Biff.
Where's the surprise, Pop?
In the back seat of the car.
Boy, what's the surprise, Dad? Tell me, what'd you buy?
Never you mind. Something I want you to have.
What is it, Ab? It's a punching bag.
Oh, Pop. It's got Gene Tunney's signature on it.
Gee, how'd you know we wanted a punching bag?
Well, it's the finest thing for the timing.
Oh, I'm losing weight. You notice, Pop?
Jumping rope is good, too.
Oh, Pop, did you see the new ball I got?
Hey, where'd you get the new ball?
Coach wanted me to practice my passing.
That's so. And he gave you the ball.
Well, I borrowed it from the locker room.
I want you to return that.
I told you he wouldn't like it.
I'm bringing it back.
Sure. He's got to practice with a regulation ball, doesn't he? Coach will probably congratulate you on your initiative.
Coach is congratulating my initiative all the time.
That's because he likes you. If someone else were to steal the ball, there'd be an uproar. So, boys, what is the report?
Where'd you go this time, Pop? Gee, we were lonesome for you.
Lonesome, huh?
Missed you every minute.
Tell you a secret, boys. Don't breathe it to a soul. Someday, I'll own my own business. And I'll never have to leave home anymore.
Like Uncle Charlie.
Bigger than Uncle Charlie. Because Charlie was not liked. He was liked, but he wasn't well liked.
Where'd you go this time, Pop?
Got on the road and went north of Providence. Met the mayor.
The mayor of Providence?
He was sitting in the hotel lobby.
Well, what'd he say?
He said, morning. And I said, you got a fine city here, mayor. And then he had a cup of coffee with me. And then I went on to Waterbury. Waterbury's a fine city. Big clock city. Famous for the Waterbury clock. Sold a nice bill there, and then on to Boston. Boston is the cradle of the revolution. A fine city. Then a few other towns in Mass, and then on to Bangor and Portland, and then straight home.
Gee, we'd love to come with you sometime, Pop.
Soon as summer comes.
Promise?
You and Hap and I, and I'll show you all the towns. America is filled with beautiful towns and fine, upstanding people. And they know me, boys, up and down New England, the finest people. When we walk into those stores, it'll be open sesame for all of us. Because one thing, boys, I have friends. I can park my car in any street in New England, and the cops protect it like their very own. This summer, how about it?
Yeah, you bet.
We'll bring our bathing suits.
We'll carry your bags, Pop.
Oh, won't that be something? It's just me and my boys walking in those Boston stores. Hey, Biff, what did they say about you now that you made captain?
There's a crowd of girls behind him every time the class has changed.
Well, are you nervous about the big game?
Not if you're going to be there. This Saturday, Pop, this Saturday just for you, I'm going to break through for a touchdown.
You're supposed to pass.
I'm taking a play for Pop, and you watch me, Pop. When I take off my helmet, that play's going to be for you. Then you watch me crash through that line.
Wait till I tell this in Boston.
Biff, where are you? You're supposed to study with me today.
Hey, look at Bernard. What you looking so anemic about,
He's
Bernard?
He's got to study, Uncle Willie. He's got Regents next week.
Let's box, Bernard.
Look, Biff. I heard Mr. Birnbaum say if you don't start studying math, he's going to flunk you and you won't graduate.
You better go and study with him, Biff.
I heard him.
Go on now.
Oh, Pop, you didn't see the new sneakers I got.
Hey, that's a beautiful job of printing.
Just because he printed University of Virginia on the sneakers doesn't mean they've got to graduate him, Uncle Willie.
What are you talking about, Bernard? With scholarships to three great universities, they're going to flunk him? Don't be a pest.
What an anemic.
Okay, I'm waiting for you in my house, Biff.
Mark's not liked, is he?
He's liked, but he's not well liked.
That's right, Pop.
That's just what I mean. Bernard can get the best marks in school, you understand, but when you both get into the business world, understand it, you will be five times ahead of him. That's why I thank Almighty God that you're both built like a donkey. Because the man who creates an impression, the man who creates a personal interest, is the man who gets ahead. Be liked, and you will never win. You take me, for instance. I never have to wait in line to see a buyer. Willie Loman is here is all they have to say, and I go right through.
Did you knock him dead, Pop?
Knocked him cold in Providence. Slaughtered them in Boston.
I'm losing weight. You notice, Pop?
Hello, dear.
Sweetheart.
How'd the Chevy run?
Chevrolet, Linda, is the finest car ever built. Marvelous. Since when do you let your mother carry the wash upstairs?
Oh, grab hold there, boy.
Oh.
Where to, Mom?
Hang them up on the line. And you better go down to your friends, Biff. The cellar is full of boys who don't know what to do with themselves.
Oh, when Pop comes home, they can wait.
You better go and tell him what to do, Biff.
I think I'll have them sweep out the furnace room.
Good work, Biff.
Fellas, everybody, sweep out the furnace room. I'll be right down. George, Sam, and Frank, come out back. We're hanging up the watch. Come on, hop on the double. Hop, hop, hop.
The way they obey him.
Well, that's the training. The training. I'm telling you, I was selling thousands and thousands, but I had to come home.
Oh, the whole block will be at that game. Did you sell anything?
Well, I did 500 gross in Providence and 700 gross in Boston.
Wait a minute, I've got a pencil. That makes your commission... $212!
Well, I hadn't figured it yet,
though. How much did you do?
Well, let's see. I did about 180 gross in Providence. That better make it 200 for the whole trip. The trouble is that three of the stores were half closed for inventory in Boston. Otherwise, I would have sold records.
Well, that makes $70 and some pennies. It's very good.
What do we owe?
On the first, there's $16 on the refrigerator.
Why 16?
Well, the fan belt broke again, so it was $1.80.
But it's brand new.
Well, that's the way the man said it is, till they work themselves in, you know?
I hope we didn't get stuck in that machine.
They got the biggest ads of any of them.
I know, it's a fine machine. What else?
There's $9.60 on the washing machine, then the roof. You got $21 remaining.
It don't leak, does it?
No, they did a wonderful job. Then you owe Frank for the carburetor.
I'm not going to pay that man. That goddamn Chevrolet, they ought to prohibit the manufacturer of that vehicle.
Well, you owe him 3.5. And odds and ends comes to about... $120 for the 15th.
$120? My God, if business don't pick up, I don't know what I'm going to do.
Well, you'll do better next week.
Oh, I'll knock him dead next week. I'll go to Boston. I very well like Boston. You know, the trouble is, Linda, I'm not well-liked.
Don't be foolish.
I know it when I walk in. They seem to laugh at me.
Why would they laugh at you? Don't talk that way, Willie.
Don't know the reason for it, but they just pass me by. Not notice.
Willie, you're doing wonderful. You're making $70 to $100 a week.
Well, I gotta be out of 10, 12 hours a day. Other men, I don't know, they do it easier.
But Willie...
I don't know why. I can't stop myself. I talk too much. A man ought to come in with a few words to say. That's one thing about Charlie. He's a man of few words, and they respect him for it.
Don't talk too much. You're just lively, that's all.
Well, I figure, what the hell? Life's short. A couple of jokes. I joke too much.
You don't joke too much, honey.
I'm fat. I'm very foolish to look at, Linda. I didn't tell you this, but last time around Christmas, I was calling on a buyer for F.H. Stewart's, and a salesman I know said something about walrus, and I just cracked him right across the face, Linda. I will not take that. I simply will not take that. But they do laugh at me. I know that.
Darling.
Gotta overcome it. I know, I just gotta overcome it. I'm not dressing to my advantage, maybe.
Darling, you're the handsomest man in the world.
Oh, no, Linda.
It's me you are. The handsomest. And your voice, Willie. Willie, few men are idolized for their children. The way you are.
You're the best there is, Linda. You know that? You're a pal. Sometimes when I'm on the road, I just want to grab you and kiss the life out of you. Because I get so lonely, especially when business is bad and there's nobody to talk to. I get the feeling that I'll never sell anything again, that I won't make a living for you or business. A business for the boys. There's so much I want to make for.
Me? You didn't make me, Willie. I picked you.
You picked me?
I did. I've been sitting at that desk watching all the salesmen go by day in and day out, but you've got such a sense of humor, and I think you're a wonderful man.
Well, why do you have to go now?
Oh, it's 2:00.
Oh, come on in.
My sisters will be scandalized. Oh, when will you be back?
Oh, 2 weeks about. Will you come up again?
Sure thing. You do make me laugh. It's good for me.
That's so. You picked me.
I did. You're just so sweet and such a kid.
Well, I'll see you in the common in Boston.
I'll put you right through to the buyers.
Right, well, bottom up.
Oh, Willie, you just kill me. And thanks for the stockings. I love a lot of stockings. Well, good night.
Good night. And keep your pores open.
Oh, Willie.
You are, Willie, the handsomest. You've got no reason to feel it.
I'm sorry, Linda. I'll make it up to you.
There's nothing to make up, dear. You're doing fine. Better than...
What's that?
Just mending my stockings. They're so expensive.
I won't have you mending stockings in this house. Now throw them out!
Where is he if he doesn't study?
You'll give him the answers.
I do, but I can't on Regents. That's a state exam. They're liable to arrest me.
Where is Biff? I'll whip him!
You better get back there, Paul, Willie. It's not nice.
Why is he taking everything?
And he's too rough with the girls. All the mothers are afraid of him.
I'll whip him.
He's driving the girl without a license.
Shut up!
All the mothers!
Shut up!
Mr. Birnbaum says he's stuck.
Get out of here,
all
will you?
All the mothers!
What's the matter with you? You want him to be a worm like Bernard? He's got spirit, personality, loaded with it, absolutely loaded with it. What's the matter? Why is he stealing? He's giving it back, isn't he? What is he taking? I never in my life told him anything but good, decent things. Why is he?
Let's go now.
Come on. Why is she waxing floors by herself? She knows every time that she does that she keels over.
Take it easy. What brought you back tonight?
I had an awful scare. I nearly hit a kid in Yonkers. Then, why did I go with my brother Ben that time? That man was a genius. That man was success incarnate. He begged me to go.
Oh, there's no use in going on about it now.
Guys, there was a man who went out with the clothes on his back and came back with diamonds.
Boy, someday I'd like to know how he did it.
What's the secret? He knew what he wanted and went out and got it. The world's an oyster, but you don't crack it open on a mattress.
Pop, I told you, I'm going to retire you for life.
You'll retire me for life on your 70 goddamn dollars a week? And your women, and your car, and your apartment, and you'll retire me? For Christ's sake, I couldn't get past Yonkers today. Where are you guys? Where are you? The woods are burning. I can't drive a car.
Is everything all right?
Yeah,
what's the matter?
Nothing. I thought I heard something. Can't we do something about the walls? You sneeze in here, and in my house, hats blow off.
Let's go to bed, Pop. Come on.
No, I'm not tired at the moment. You go on without me.
Take it easy, huh?
What are you doing up?
Oh, couldn't sleep. Had heartburn.
Well, you're ignorant. You gotta know about vitamins and things like that.
Nah, come on. Let's shoot. Tie you out a little.
All right. You got the cards?
Yeah, I got them. Someplace. So, what is it about those vitamins?
Well, they build up your bones. Chemistry.
Yeah, but there are no bones and heartburn.
What are you talking about? You know the first thing about it.
Don't get insulted.
Don't talk about something you don't know anything about.
So what are you doing home?
A little trouble with the car.
Oh. You know, I'd like to take a trip up to California.
Don't say.
You want a job?
I got a job. Told you that. What the hell are you offering me a job for?
Don't get insulted.
Don't insult me.
I just don't see no sense in it, Willie. You don't have to go on like this.
I got a good job. What do you keep coming in here for anyhow?
You want me to go?
Charlie. He's going back to Texas again. What the hell is that?
Let him go.
I got nothing to give him, Charlie. I'm clean. I'm clean.
Well, he won't starve. None of them starve. Forget about him.
What have I got to remember?
Willie, you take it too hard. When a deposit bottle is broken, you don't get your nickel back.
That's easy enough for you to say.
No, that ain't easy for me to say.
You see the ceiling I put up in the living room?
Yeah, that's a piece of work. Put up a ceiling is a mystery to me. How do you do it?
What's the difference?
Well, talk about it.
Are you going to put up a ceiling?
How could I put
up a ceiling? Then what the hell are you bothering me for?
You're insulted again.
A man who doesn't know how to handle tools is not a man. You're disgusting.
Now don't call me disgusting, Willie.
Getting awful tired, Ben.
Good. Keep playing. I'll sleep better. Did you call me Ben?
That's funny. For a second there, you reminded me of my brother Ben.
I only have a few minutes.
You never heard from him again, huh? Since that time?
Didn't Linda tell you? We got a letter from his wife in Africa a couple of weeks ago. He died.
That's so.
So this is Brooklyn, eh?
Well, maybe you're in for some of his money.
He had 7 sons. There's just one opportunity I had with that man.
I must make a train, William. There are several properties I'm looking at in Alaska.
Sure. I'd gone with him to Alaska that time. Everything would have been totally different.
Go on, you'd froze to death up there.
What are you talking about?
Opportunity's tremendous in Alaska, William. Surprised you're not up there.
Sure. Tremendous.
Huh?
Bear was the only man I ever met who knew all the answers.
Who? How are you all?
Fine, fine.
Pretty sharp tonight.
Is Mother living with you?
No, she died a long time ago.
Shame. Fine specimen of a lady, Mother.
Who?
Huh?
I'd hope to see the old girl.
Who died?
Heard anything from Father, have you?
What do you mean, who died?
What are you talking about?
William, it's 8:30.
That's my build!
No, I put the ace.
If you don't know how to play the game, I'm not gonna throw my money away on you!
It was my ace, for God's sake!
I'm through!
When did Mother die?
Long ago. Since the beginning, you never knew how to play cards!
Fine, next time I'm making a deck with 5 aces.
I don't play that kind of game!
You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Yeah!
Yeah!
Ignoramus! Ben, I've been waiting for you for so long. What's the answer? How did you do it?
Oh, there's a story in that.
Is this Ben?
How do you do, my dear?
Where have you been all these years? Willie always wondered where.
Where's Dad? Didn't you follow him? How'd you get started?
Well, I don't know how much you remember.
Well, I was just a baby, of course. 3 or 4 years old.
3 years and 11 months.
What a memory, Ben.
I've had many enterprises, William, and I've never kept books.
I remember I was sitting under the wagon in, what was it, Nebraska?
It was South Dakota. I gave you a bunch of wildflowers.
The flowers, that's right. And you were walking down some open country road.
I was going to find Father in Alaska.
Did you ever find him?
Well, at that time I had a rather faulty view of geography. Instead of going north, I discovered that I was going south. I ended up in Africa instead of Alaska.
Africa?
The Gold Coast.
Principally diamond mines.
Diamond mines?
Yes, but I haven't...
No, wait, Ben. Boys, get out of here. This is your Uncle Ben, boys. A great man. Tell my boys, Ben.
Why, boys? When I was 17, I walked into the jungle. I was 21, I walked out. And by God, I was rich.
See, boys? The greatest things can happen.
I have an appointment in Ketchikan.
No, wait. Ben, please tell about that. I want them to hear. I want them to know the kind of stock they spring from. All I remember is a man with a bushy beard sitting around a fire, and I was on Mama's lap, and there was some kind of high music.
His flute. He played the flute.
That's right. The flute.
Father was a very great and a very wild-hearted man. We'd start in Boston, and we'd toss the family into the wagon. And he'd drive the team across the country. Through Ohio, Indiana, Michigan, Illinois, all the western states. We'd stop in the town and sell the flutes he'd made along the way. Great inventor, Father. With one gadget, he made more in a week than a man like you could make in a lifetime.
That's just the way I'm bringing them up, Ben. Rugged, well-liked, all around.
Hit that boy, hard as he can.
Oh, no, sir.
Show him, Biff.
Oh, come on, get to me.
All right.
Why must they fight, dear?
Oh, good boy.
How's that, Ben?
Give him the left, Biff.
Why are you fighting?
Good boy.
Get
there! Gee! Never fight fair with a stranger, boy. You'll never make it out of the jungle that way. It was an honor and a pleasure to meet you.
Have a nice trip.
And you. Good luck with your... What do you do?
Selling.
Yes, well...
No, wait, Ben. I don't want you to think. Listen, it's Brooklyn, I know, but we hunt too.
Really now?
Oh, sure, there's snakes, rabbits, and that's why we moved out here. Why, Biff can fell any one of those trees in no time. Boys, go over to where they're building that new apartment house and get some sand. We're going to rebuild the front stoop right away. Watch this, man.
Yes, sir. Come on, hop on the double.
I lost weight, Pop. You notice?
They threw any more from that building to watch me put the cops on.
Oh, no, don't let them.
You should have seen the lumber they brought home last week. A dozen 6x10s, worth all kinds of money.
Willie, if that watchman...
I gave him hell, understand, but I got a couple of fearless characters over there.
Willie, the jails are full of fearless characters.
And the stock exchange, friend.
Hey, Charlie, where are the rest of your pants?
My wife bought them.
Well, now you can get a golf club, go upstairs, and go to sleep. Great athlete. Between him and his son, Bernard, they can't hammer a nail.
How'd you do in Portland this trip?
Decapitated them, Charlie. Ben, I can't handle the volume.
He would have done better if the stores hadn't...
I had the greatest week in my history.
The watchman's chasing Biff!
Shut up, he's not doing anything!
Where is he? Biff!
What's the matter with you?
Nervy boy.
Oh, nerves have I heard that, Biff.
Don't know how you do the business, really. Salesmen all over the city coming back bleeding from New England. Can't sell a nickel for 3 cents yet. Hitting pretty great, aren't you?
Contacts, Charlie. I got important contacts.
Glad to hear it. Why don't you come in later? We'll shoot a little casino. Take some of your Portland money.
Business is bad, but not for me, of course.
I'll stop by on my way back to Africa.
No, wait, Ben. Can't you stay? You're just what I need, Ben, because... Listen, I have a fine position here, but Father left when I was such a baby, and I still feel kind of temporary about myself.
I'll be late for my train.
No, wait, Ben. My boys. Can't we talk? They go into the jaws of hell for me, understand?
William, you're being first-rate with your boys. Outstanding manly chaps.
Oh, Ben, that's good to hear, because sometimes I'm afraid I'm not... Ben, how should I teach him?
William, when I walked into the jungle, I was 17. And when I walked out, I was 21. And by God, I was rich.
Was rich. That's just the way I want to bring him up, Ben. To walk into a jungle. I was right. I was right. I was right. All along, I was right. I was right. I knew it. Told me I was wrong, but I was right.
It's very late, darling. Did you have some cheese?
Gotta break your neck to see a star in this yard.
You coming in?
Whatever happened to that diamond watch fob Ben brought for me from Africa that time? Remember that Romeo watch fob with a diamond in it?
You pawned it, dear. 12 or 13 years ago for this radio correspondence course.
Gee, that was a beautiful thing. I'll take a walk.
But you're in your slippers.
I was right, Ben. There was a man
but
worth
in your
talking
slippers?
To. I was right.
Really?
I was right.
What's he doing out there?
Shh.
My God, Mom, how long has he been doing this for?
Don't. He'll hear you.
What the hell is the matter with him?
It'll pass by morning.
Shouldn't we do anything?
My dear, you should do a lot of things. But there's nothing to do now, so go to sleep.
Never heard him so loud, Mom.
Come around more often, and you'll hear him.
Why didn't you ever write me about this, Mom?
How would I write to you? For over 3 months, you had no address.
I was on the move. But, you know, I thought of you all the time. You do know that, don't you, Belle?
I know, dear. But he likes to have a letter. Just to know, there's still the possibility for better things.
He's not like this all the time, is he?
It's worse when you come.
When I come?
When you write you're coming, he's all smiles. He talks of the future, and he's wonderful. And then the closer you seem to come, the more shaky he gets. By the time you get here, he's arguing. And he seems angry at you, and I just don't think he can open up to you. Why are you so hateful to each other? Why is that?
I'm not hateful, Mom.
But no sooner you walk in the door than you're fighting.
I don't know. I mean to change. I'm trying, Mom. You understand?
Are you home to stay?
I don't know. I want to look around and see what's doing.
Biff, a man can't look around all his life.
I just can't take hold, Mom. I can't take hold of some kind of a life.
Biff, a man is not a bird to come and go with the springtime.
Your hair. Your hair got so gray.
It's been gray since you were in high school. I just stopped dyeing it, that's all.
Well, dye it again, will you? I don't want my pal looking so old.
You're such a boy! You think you can go away for a year and... One day, you'll come knocking on this door. And there'll be strange people here.
Well, Mom, what are you talking about? You're not even 60.
But what about your father?
I meant him, too.
He admires Pop.
Biff, if you don't have any feeling for him, you can't possibly have any feeling for me.
Sure I can, Mom.
No. No, because I love him. He is the dearest man in the world to me. And I won't have anyone making him feel unwanted and low and blue. Now, I know he's not the easiest man to get along with. Nobody knows that better than me. I just think you need to understand that.
Well, sure.
You're never around.
Hey! Hey, Biffo!
What the hell is the matter with him?
Don't go near him!
Stop making excuses for him. He has always wiped the floor with you. Never had an ounce of respect for you.
He's always had
now,
respect
what do you know about it?
Just don't call him crazy.
He's got no character. Charlie wouldn't do that. Not in his own home, spewing out that vomit from his mind.
Charlie's never had to cope with what he's got to.
Oh, people are worse off than Willie Loman. Believe me, I've seen them.
Then make Charlie your father, Biff! You can't do that, can you? No. I don't say he's a great man. Willie Loman never made a lot of money. His name was never in the paper. He's not the finest character to ever live. But he's a human being. And a terrible thing has happened to him. He's not allowed to fall into his grave like an old dog. Attention must finally be paid to such a person. You You've called him crazy.
Mom, I didn't mean
No! A lot of people think he's lost his balance. But you don't have to be very smart to know what his trouble is. The man is exhausted.
Of course.
A small man can be just as exhausted as a great man. He works for a company 36 years this March, opens up unheard of territory to their trademark. And now, in his old age, they take away his salary.
I didn't know that, Mom.
You never asked, my dear. Now that you get your spending money someplace else, you don't trouble your mind with him.
I gave you money last...
Christmas time, $50. To fix the hot water heater, it costs $97.50. For 5 weeks, he's been on straight commission. Like a beginner, an unknown.
Those ungrateful bastards.
Are they any worse than his sons? When he brought them business, when he was young, they were glad to see him. But now his old friends, the old buyers who loved him so, always found some order to hand him in a pinch. They're all dead. Tired. He used to be able to make 6-7 calls a day in Boston. Now he takes his valises out of the car and puts them back and takes them out again, and he's exhausted! Instead of walking, he talks now. He drives 700 miles, and when he gets there, no one knows him anymore. No one welcomes him. And what goes through a man's mind driving 700 miles home without having earned a cent? Why shouldn't he talk to himself? Why? When he has to go to Charlie and borrow $50 a week and pretend to me it's his pay?
God!
How long can that go on? You see what I'm sitting here and waiting for, boys? And you tell me he has no character. The man who never worked a day but for your benefit. When does he get the medal? Is this his reward? To turn around at the age of 63 and find his sons who he loved better than his life. What a philandering bum!
Mom!
That is all you are, my baby. And you, what happened to the love you had for him? You were such pals. How you used to talk to him on the phone every night. How lonely he was when he could come home to you.
All right. All right, Mom, I'll stay in my room and I'll get a job. I'll just keep away from him, that's all.
No. Biff, you can't stay here and fight all the time.
He threw me out of the house, remember that?
Why did he do that? I never knew.
Because I know he's a fake, and he doesn't like anybody around who knows.
Why a fake? In what way?
Never mind. Just don't lay it all to me, all right? It's between me and him. That's all I have to say about it. I'll chip in from now on. He'll settle for half my salary. He's going to be all right, Mom. I'm going to sleep.
He won't be all right.
I hate this city, and I'll stay here. Now, what do you want from me?
He's dying, Biff.
Why is he dying?
Been trying to kill himself.
How?
I live from day to day.
What are you talking about?
Last month. Do you remember when I wrote to you that I smashed up the car again last February?
Well?
Well, the insurance inspector came. They said that they have evidence that all these accidents in the last year weren't accidents.
How can they tell that? That's a lie.
Well, it seems there was this woman, and this
woman...
What?
Nothing, go ahead.
What did you say?
Nothing, I just said, what woman? What about her?
Well, it seems she was walking along and saw his car. That he wasn't driving fast at all, and he didn't skid. She says that he came to that little bridge on the road and deliberately smashed into the railing, and it was only the shallowness of the water that saved him.
Probably just fell asleep again, Mom.
I don't think he fell asleep.
Why not?
Last month... Oh, it's so hard to say a thing like this. He's just a big, stupid man to you, but I tell you, there's more good in him than a lot of other people. I was looking for the fuse box. The lights blew out, and I went down to the cellar. And behind the fuse box, it just happened to fall out. It was the length of a little rubber pipe, just short.
No kidding.
I knew right away, and sure enough, on the bottom of the water heater... was a new little nipple.
That jerk. Did you have it taken off?
I'm ashamed to. How can I mention it to him? Every day I go down to the cellar and take it away, and when he comes home, I put it right back. How can I insult him in that way? I know every thought in his mind. I know it sounds silly and old-fashioned, but I tell you, he put his whole life into you. And you've turned your backs on him. Biff, I swear to God, his life is in your hands.
How do you like that, you damn fool? All right, Mom, all right. It's all settled now, okay? I've been remiss, I know that, Mom. But now I'll stay, and I swear to you I'll apply myself. It's just I don't fit in business. Not that I won't try. I'll try, and I'll make good.
Sure you will. The trouble with you in business was you never tried to please anyone.
I know.
Yeah. Like when you worked for the Harrisons. Bob Harrison said you were tops, and then you do some damn fool thing like whistling whole songs in the elevator like a comedian.
So what? I like to whistle sometimes.
You don't raise a guy to a responsible job who whistles in the elevator.
Don't argue about it now.
And like when you'd go off for a swim when you were supposed to be taking the line around.
So what? You run off, don't you, on a nice summer day?
Yeah, but I cover myself.
Boys!
I'm going to take a fade. The boss can call any number where I'm supposed to be, and they'll swear to him that I just left. I hate to tell you this, Biff, but in the business world, some people think you're crazy.
Well, screw the business world!
All right, great, screw it, but cover yourself!
Half.
I don't care what you think! They've laughed at Dad for years, and you know why? Because we don't belong in this nut house of a city! We should be on an open field mixing cement or carpenters. A carpenter is allowed to whistle.
Even your grandfather was better than a carpenter. You never grew up. Bernard does not whistle in the elevator, I assure you.
Yeah, but you do, Pop.
Me? Never in my life have I whistled on an elevator. And who the hell thinks I'm crazy?
I didn't mean it like that. Don't make a whole big
thing. Go back west, will you? Be a cowboy, a carpenter. Enjoy yourself.
Willie, he was just
saying. I heard what he said.
Pop, come on now.
They think I'm crazy, huh? Go to Filene's, the hub, Slattery's, Boston. Yell the name Willie Loman and see what happens to you, big shot.
All right, Pop.
Big.
All right.
Why do you always insult me?
I didn't say a word. Did I say a word?
You didn't say anything, Willie.
All right. Good night.
Willie?
Oh, and if you decide to do something tomorrow instead of hanging around the house all day, why don't you paint the ceiling I put up?
I'm leaving early tomorrow.
He's going to see Bill Oliver, Pop.
Oliver? For what?
He always said he'd stake me. I'm interested in going in business, so I thought I'd take him up on it.
Isn't that wonderful?
Don't interrupt. What's so wonderful about it? There's 50 men in the city of New York who'd stake him. Sporting Goods?
Yeah, well, I know a thing about it.
He knows something about it. You know Sporting Goods better than Spalding, for God's sake. How much is he giving you?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I haven't even seen him yet.
Oh, I see. You're counting your chickens again.
Jesus Christ, I'm going
to... Don't curse in this house.
Yeah, when you do get so clean...
I won't have you using that language at me. Now cut it out!
Wait a minute. I've got an idea. I've got a feasible idea. Come on, Biff. Let's talk some sense here. When I was down in Florida the last time, I had the great idea to sell Sporting Goods. It just came back to me. We have a line. Loman line. We train for a couple weeks and put on a couple of exhibitions, see?
That's an idea.
Oh, wait. We form two basketball teams. Two water polo teams. They play each other. It's $1 million worth of publicity. Two brothers, see? With banners, displays in the royal palms, and banners in the rings in all the hotels.
That is a $1 million idea.
Marvelous.
I'm in great shape as far as that's concerned.
Beauty of it is, Biff, it wouldn't be like a business. You'd be out playing ball again.
$1 million.
And you wouldn't get fed up with it, Biff. There'd be the old family honor, comradeship, and if you wanted to go off for a swim or something, well, you'd do it without some smart cookie getting up ahead of you.
Lick the world! Two guys together could absolutely lick the civilized world!
See Bill Oliver tomorrow, half if we could work
maybe
that out.
Maybe things are beginning to...
Don't interrupt. But don't wear a sport jacket and slacks when you see Oliver tomorrow.
I won't.
Business suit and talk as little as possible, and don't crack any jokes.
He did like me, always did like
me. He loved you.
Will you let me talk? Walking very serious, not applying for a boy's job. There's money to pass. Be quiet, fine, and serious. Everybody loves a kidder, but nobody lends him money.
I'll try to get some myself, Biff. I'm sure I can.
I see great things for you boys. I think your troubles are all over. But remember, start big, and you'll end big. Ask for $15,000.
Huh?
How much are you going to ask for?
Gee, I hadn't
and
even
And don't
finished.
Say G. G is a boy's word. A man walking in for $15,000 does not say G.
10, though I think would be top.
Don't be so modest. You always started too low. Walking with a big laugh, right in the mood. Don't start off with a couple of your good stories that get things off, because it's not what you say, it's how you say it. Because personality always wins the day.
Oliver, always on
Will
the high!
Will you let me talk?
Hey, stop yelling at her.
I was talking, wasn't I?
I just don't like you yelling at her all the time, that's all I'm saying.
What, are you taking over this house?
Willie!
Stop taking this side all the time, goddammit!
Hey, stop yelling at her!
Do my best to Oliver. He may remember me.
What did you do that for? You see how sweet he was when you started talking hopefully? Come up and say goodnight. Don't let him go to bed that way.
Come on, Biff. Let's buck him up.
Please, dear. So say goodnight. It takes so little to make him happy. Your pajamas are hanging in the bathroom, Willie.
What a woman. They broke the mold when they made her. You know that, Biff?
He's off salary. My God, working on commission.
Well, let's face it, he's no hotshot selling man. Though at times, you have to admit, he's a sweet personality.
Can you do anything about the shower? It drips.
All of a sudden, everything falls to pieces. Goddamn plumbing ought to be sued!
Lend me $10, will you? I want to buy some new ties.
I'll take you to a place I know. Beautiful stuff. And wear one of my striped shirts tomorrow.
She got gray. Mom got awful old. Gee, I'm going to see Bill Oliver tomorrow, and I'm going to knock him for one.
Come on, let's sell that to Dad. Let's give him a whirl.
$10,000, boy.
There we go, Biff. That's the first time I've heard the old confidence out of you. You and me, Biff, we're going to live together, and I'm telling you, any babe you want.
I'm wondering if Oliver will remember him. You think he might?
Remember him? Are you crazy? Of course I'll remember him. Why, if he'd stayed with Oliver, he'd be on top by now. Because, you don't know the average caliber walking in today. The average man today has got a caliber of zero. Why, the greatest thing for him to do is to bum around.
Come on, Biff. Pop, he wanted to say goodnight to you, sport.
Glad to hear it. Well, what is it you wanted to tell me?
Just take it easy, Pop. Good night.
Oh, and Biff, if something falls on the floor tomorrow, like a package or something, don't you pick it up. I got office boys for that.
I'll make a big breakfast.
Will you stop? And remember, no less than $15,000.
All right, Pop.
Because you got greatness in you, kid. You got all kinds of greatness.
Good night, Mom.
Sleep well, dear.
I'm going to get married, Mom. Wanted to tell you.
Go to sleep, dear.
Keep up the good work.
Just wanted to tell you.
Rest, dear. Should I sing to you?
Yeah, sing to me. Remember that Ebbets Field game? The championship of the city? When he came out, he was the tallest. Remember?
Oh, yeah, and in gold, too.
Like a young guy. Hercules. Something like that. When he came out on the field, he waved to me, remember? With the representatives of three colleges standing by. And the fires I bought with me, and the cheers when he came out on the field. Lowman! 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 God almighty, he'll be great yet. A star like that? Magnificent. Can never really fade away.
Willie?
Don't talk anymore. I'm so tired.
You going to talk to Howard tomorrow?
First thing in the morning. Everything will be all right. Gee, look at the moon moving between the buildings.